Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today we are going to build Linux. So we are going to look at what Linux is and everything that has to do with Linux. I use Linux every day at work and I think it's a very powerful operating system. And in this video, we are going to build Linux from scratch. And it will probably be a series because it can take some time to do this. And if you want to follow along, just visit Linux from scratch and the documentation will be there for you. And more than that, you will need to set up your own, let's say, either you set up a computer or you need to set up a virtual environment. As you see here, I have a virtual environment with Ubuntu. I think pretty much any new distro will work for you, but you need to have a live CD and some hard disk space to follow along in this video. So first off, I wanted to talk a little bit about the Linux system and the different directories that you have in your root directory. So you see here that you have a lot of directories. They have names. Most of the names are shortened, so they will be snappy and easy to find. So we will go through them all. First, we have the bin directory. This is for the system binaries, and these are binaries that anyone can run and use. So these are typically tools that you can list things in your environment, or read documents and so on. So these are useful system tools that are available in this bin directory. Then we have the boot directory. Here your boot files will be located. For instance, images that will start when you're booting your Linux environment. Then we have the CD-ROM, and in this case, I guess it's the actual CD-ROM that I have booted here. Then you have a dev directory, and this directory will have all your devices. So it will have your hard drives, it will have your sound card, or yeah, anything that you plug into your computer or have in your computer will be under devices. Etc is your configuration directory. Here you will have all the system configuration for your system. And this etc directory you can find in other locations as well, but the root location here, you see that I'm actually at slash, and slash is the root of a Linux directory tree. So this is as far down in the system that you can get, and etc at that level is for the whole system. And then we come to the home directory, and this is for all the users of the Linux environment to have their own home directories that they can have their own files. For instance, you can have your documents or anything that you work with, you have in your home directory. And then we have the lib directory, and these are for libraries. So there's this every tool or every binary that you build in your system might use a library. And the library has extra functionality that your applications uses. And a Linux system is built on under a principle that you build small, usable things that a lot of different processes can use. And this library folder will have all the functionality that the different application needs in small forms, so they can reuse all that functionality. Then they have the media folder, and this is usually where you put CD-ROM drives, CD-ROMs and anything that you mount in your system that is external, like CD-ROMs or USBs or anything like that. Then you have the mount MNT directory, and this is where you usually mount like external drives, or you can mount your CD-ROMs there as well. What you actually use the directories for is a little bit up to you, but they have a connotation, a specific meaning when you go into the system. Then you have the optional directory. And this directory I usually use for building packages that isn't a system package or doesn't come with the actual build environment or the package system or anything like that. So stuff that I download myself and I want to build and install in the system, I usually use the opt directory for that. Then we have the proc directory. And the proc directory is process information. So in this directory, you can find CPU info, for instance, and that will tell you everything that you need to know about your CPU. So it will save files or points where you can actually read more information about the different system processes. You can read more information about your graphics card and so on. So this directory you go into if you want to figure out what graphics card is the system running at the moment, so you can find the right drivers and so on. Then we have row FS, and this is probably something specific to this CD-ROM drive. It's not a directory I've seen before. Then you have the root directory, and this is for the root user. You usually have one user in the system that is the administrator and the one that will install all system binaries and so on. And they have their own home directory that is not located in home, and this is called root. And you should not confuse that with the actual root directory, which is slash. So this is the user roots directory. And then you have the run directory. The run directory is a directory where all the files that tells the system that this specific process is already running. So in this directory, you can put files like PID files that says that this system process is already running, don't start it again. So that's the kind of files you can put there in. Then you have SBIN, and SBIN is exactly like the bin directory. The difference with SBIN directories is that those are for the system user. So this is super user binaries. So these are more for handling the system, and these are usually locked, so you as normal user can't use these binaries. And then we have a snap directory. Haven't seen that, don't know what it is. SRV is the system services you can find there. And in this Ubuntu environment, you have a sys directory also. And I'm not really sure what you would put in a system directory. That's not a normal directory either. But you can find them in some distributions. They might put their own binaries and so on in there. Then you have the temp directory, TMP. And this is just for temporary files. It will be cleaned up every time you reset your system. We have the USR directory, and this is for user binaries. So in this directory, you will have a bin and a sysbin, and these are all the binaries and libraries that are installed as user binaries. So it's not required for the system. It's something that you want to have because you want to run a specific binary. For instance, if you want a word processor, you might install LibreOffice under user binaries. It's not required for the system to run, but it's something that you might want to use in your system. And then we have var, and that's variable data. So in this directory, you can find everything that is something that you save as data in the system. For instance, databases, you can save log files, and so on. So that's more of a data dir with all the data dependencies and so on. So now we have talked about all the directories. And why did I talk about the directories? This is because the first thing that you need to do when you set up a new Linux environment is to decide how should my disk be partitioned. What things do I want to have on my hard drive for the system? And that can be a hard decision to do if you don't know what the different directories actually mean. What you absolutely need when you set up a system is a swap dir, and that's a directory or a swap partition, and that's for memory swapping. So when you use your memory and that might not be enough, it will use this partition to actually swap your memory out so you get a little bit more memory in your system. So that's something that you usually create. And a swap partition is usually either as large as the system memory or the double size of your system memory. Then we have the root directory, and that's the directory that I'm in at the moment. That everything is in the root directory, so you need one of those. But the different directories in your root can also be mounted to specific partitions. So for instance, you can say that I want a root directory that is 20 gigabytes. And then I want a home directory that is 2 terabytes. Because I expect that I will have users that will use their home directory and have a lot of documents there. So that's a way to say that I want a lot of hard disk space allocated to the home directory. And you can do the same for system user binaries. You can have a partition for that and say that that should be a couple of gigabytes. And if you partition the different directories in your system, that is the allocation that you do at that time. So for instance, if you say that I have a home directory of 1 gigabyte and I have a system directory of 20 gigabytes, let's say, might be a bit strange to say that. But let's say that we do it like that, and the user will use more than 1 gigabyte. Well, that directory and that drive is full. And that's important to know, because if you have a home directory that is separated to your root, then the system will not go down because it doesn't have any hard drive space, because the home directory is locked to that gigabyte that you gave that home directory, and they can't exceed that because it's not the same drive. That's important. I think I will break this video here. So this video will be a series with lots of different videos. I hope that you found this video interesting. I hope that you learned a little bit more about Linux, and I hope that you like this video. Give it a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section down below. And I really hope to see you in the next video.